The oil industry in Alaska is the number one business here. It's pretty much the life's blood of the state.
The oil industry is worth around $9 billion a year to Alaska.
We put a popper in between the engines and these pipe loads. The reason we do that is because the pipe loads could shift. If they shift, they could damage the locomotives. Those are $2 million locomotives apiece. We have six of them up here today. So we do not want to damage those engines. We only have so many on this property, so they're very important to protect them. Everything looks real good. Looks good. Let's get busy.
Railroad hauls more pipe for the North Slope oil industry than any other means of transportation. We each help each other exist, so hopefully that trend will continue.
It's now 8 a.m. They have a seven-hour journey ahead that will take them through woodlands notorious for deadly collisions with wildlife and ice-packed tunnels running through the Kenai Mountains. They want to arrive at Anchorage by 4 p.m.
Constantly on the lookout for anything that would affect the movement and safety of this train. Got mirrors placed on the sides of locomotives. You can look back and see behind you. You look out in front, critters come out, humanoids. Just gotta stay alert and aware. If a critter did come out of the woods, we try to make noise and get it to move out of the way, try to slow down.
I mean, we hit moose, we've hit caribou, we've hit black bears, grizzly bears. It's kind of gory sometimes.
Trains on this line hit more moose than any other animal. They find it difficult to walk through deep snow, preferring instead to use the snow-cleared tracks. Exceptionally heavy snowfall last year lured many moose onto the rail line, and nearly 300 were killed in collisions.
Have no incidents. We'll see some critters and they'll be a ways away and they'll look good and they won't get hurt at all.
Watch out!
Oh, just hit a dog. Didn't have a chance.
He's done.
Well, we hit a dog and
damn it!
Obviously nothing we could do there.
Yeah, it's a shame, but it happens.
Yeah, it does. Don't like doing it, though. Kind of sucks.
Danny and Animal's freight train is almost halfway on its journey to Anchorage. They're carrying 2,000 tons of drill pipe for a new oil mining company.
Climbing the hill, baby, climbing the hill.
There are more than 20 billion barrels of crude oil buried beneath Alaska's North Slope.
Pipe's all on still?
Yeah, pipe's looking good, Rashad.
All right.
Keeping 200 drill sites supplied with equipment in the extreme winters is a constant battle for the railroad, but vital for the state's economy.
Nice thing about the loop is we can actually really look at our train. We can see most of it now.
Beauty that's out here that you get to see. We've all been over this probably thousands of times each, but you never get used to it. It's fabulous.
Forty miles ahead, five tunnels cut right through the Kenai Mountains. This is a notorious danger zone, where 30-foot-long killer icicles hang right above the track. Roadmaster Bruce Goff and his crew are on a routine call to inspect this section of line and check that it's safe for the freight train to pass through.
We have a northbound freight coming through. We want to make sure the ice is clear of the tunnels. The Alaska Railroad right now is going through some economic challenges, but you can't really let it affect you. You still have to get these trains safely to their destinations. Got concerned about this ice here, overhang, could strike our trains.
Icicles like this can weigh more than 20 tons. If they break free, they can smash into a passing train and possibly derail it.
Here we go.
They're too high for excavators to reach, so the solution? Shoot them down.
Well, that's a big chunk of ice.
Yeah, that thing's massive. I think you need a rocket launcher. That'd definitely do some damage to a train or a high rail.
Oh, yeah. And let's just throw one round in it and see what it does. This is a 45-70 rifle, and I'm thinking this might be the ticket.
Let's see how good a shot you are.
Bruce has only 30 minutes to make the area safe before Danny and Animal's freight train arrives.
Give her hell, Bruce.
Let's make it look like summertime.
That's a tough one.
Yeah. It's fairly thick ice.
Yeah, I think you got your work cut out for you on that one.
One more good one.
I'm trying to just cut a little line across it. I think it's pretty solid. It might be too thick.
We got trains coming. We need to get those down. I think you might get it on this one.
The train's getting close.
There she goes. Good shooting, Bruce.
But now, the track is completely blocked with huge chunks of ice.
That's a big chunk.
That's massive.
Yeah.
The hard part of this is to get the ice removed from the ditch line, clear the tracks up, because we got to get this train through. He is doing really good.
And did you hear anything on that train yet?
We're running out of time.
Well, let's get out of here.
Yeah, let's get this thing in the hole.
Right now, we've done our job. Our next big thing is just get off the tracks and get this freight moved.
Moment of truth.
Yeah, see what we get here.
It's a crapshoot. You take your chances and...
That's all you can do.
You gotta slow down to less than 15.
Vibrations from the train could loosen the icicles above their heads.
See all that ice?
To reduce the risk of an icicle hit, they slow down to less than 10 miles an hour.
I get way more concerned with this than what's inside that tunnel.
That stuff there. Great big icicles. It's a little unnerving sometimes traveling underneath that. Some of that ice up there is 30, 40 feet long, 5 feet thick.
I'd say some of that could be easily 20 tons, easily.
It could break loose, cut through this cab like a knife going through butter.
Water seeping through the holes in the tunnel's walls freezes solid, creating even more icicles.
I've actually had ice come down, tear the mirrors off a locomotive. Look at that ice chunk. Yikes.
I see the light.
Oh, yeah.
Made it.
Job well done.
We are north of tunnel.
Thank you very much. 1080 out.